In this video, we're going to show how a sequence is bounded. We're going to find the boundary value. Okay, so the sequence in question is going to be 3n squared minus 2 over n squared plus 1. Okay, so in order for us to find the boundary value, the value that we will bound this given sequence, we have to have that the absolute value of a n subscript n is less than or equal to m. Okay, for all n, where m is a positive number. Okay, so let's put this in the absolute value symbol and see what we're going to get. So we're going to get 3n squared minus 2 over n squared plus 1. And since 3n squared is always going to be positive and n squared plus 1 is positive, we can just write it simply without the absolute value like this. And now notice that this is going to be less than 3n squared over n squared plus 1. Why? Because if you add 2, you will make the numerator bigger. So as a result, the fraction will become bigger, the number represented by the fraction, right? And now also notice that we can make it even bigger by adding, by subtracting 1 from the denominator, right? So you're making the denominator smaller, and then in return, you're making this fraction bigger, right? Because the denominator got smaller, so you will have n squared. And now notice that the n squared can be canceled, and that means that the boundary value is going to be 3. Okay, so the sequence is bounded by 3. So its highest value will be 3. It will never exceed 3. Okay? This is all it means. It might not necessarily be the limit value of the sequence, but it will never exceed 3. It's going to be the highest value. It could be the starting value of the sequence. I'm not going to go into determining what the sequence is doing or when it's going to arrive at 3. Well, in this case, it's going to be its limit value, right? Because if you take the limit of this sequence as n approaches infinity, you will see that the limit value will be 3. So in this case, it's the limit value that's also the boundary value. Okay, the highest value, the greatest value for the sequence. But it may not necessarily be true for other sequences. Sometimes sequences start from the highest value and they go down, okay? But in any case, this is going to be the boundary value for this sequence. I hope this tutorial was useful. Please subscribe and I'll see you in my next video.